are dealing with across the state, and many of them are due to COVID.
So are we at the point now where there will be a delay in responding to emergency calls? Boston 25 News reporter Wale Aliyu went searching for that answer tonight.
With the new Omicron surge, we've seen police and fire departments around the country reporting issues. In New York, for example, residents were asked to only call 911 in life or death situations. So we wanted to see if the problem was that bad here.
Police and fire chiefs are seeing firsthand that everyone's individual decision to stay safe could have a larger impact on their community, including whether there are enough available first responders.
How worried are you right now?
Well, we could get to that point if the numbers don't stop, get worse, and you know, certainly I can't predict that. You know, we may have to go to different things.
About 60% of Lawrence PD has tested positive for COVID since the pandemic began, but half of that number has tested positive in the last few weeks.
We're a bigger department. You may have a small department with only 15, 20 people, but for them to lose five or six, is significant. It's not just police and fire as well. City Hall had to close for a little bit.
50 miles away in Worcester, about 60 firefighters tested positive just last week. Last Thursday, they implemented a daily testing policy for every firefighter before they start their shift, and now that number is down to 35. But another 27 are pending results, and 19 are awaiting their five-day period before they can take a test.
Since we started that process, we've had 11 positives on the daily testing. Those 11 positives have prevented approximately 65 at-work exposures.
Worcester Acting Fire Chief says more departments statewide may follow, since firefighters are having to work in close proximity for 24-hour shifts. But those shifts have become even longer. For them, Omicron means overtime.
The first plan of action we took was December 12th. No more ship outs. Everyone worked at their own firehouse, and we backfilled in those firehouses with overtime.
Once you start forcing one shift, it just kind of continues to roll over and roll over. And by the time you get into it, 3 days, a week, and 10 days, a lot of people are working a lot of hours.
And we've done extensive reporting on how excessive overtime like this can diminish their quality of work. Both agencies do, however, tell me they will do whatever it takes to continue protecting the city. For now, it's very latest in Walpole.